Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Learning. As we know that the Savitribai Phule Pune University has declared their paper pattern, so I am here with the series of MCQ of Cost and Works Accounting 2nd. Today I am presenting in front of you the MCQs of process costing. So before we begin with the understanding of various MCQs, let me have small introduction on the topic, what do you mean by process costing? So process costing is that form of operation costing which is applicable where goods are produced with the help of sequence of continuous repeated process. Basically, process costing is applicable in manufacturing units where the continuous process is carried out. One of the most important feature of process costing is that it produces the standardized and homogeneous product. While we are learning with process costing, the next most important topic under this heading is joint product and byproduct. So what is joint product? Joint product are two or more product separated in the course of same processing, and each of that product is having high significant value as compared to their main product. When we talk about byproduct, so byproduct are the product of relatively small value as compared to main product. And they are incidentally produced, and we can't avoid the production of byproduct under process costing. So let's begin with the MCQs of process costing with their answers. So the first question is, which method of costing used to calculate the cost of product at each stage of manufacture? We are here with the option contract costing, process costing, job costing and batch costing. So the correct answer is process costing. So if you go through in the detail of process costing, we have to calculate the cost of a product at each processes. The each process under process costing provides you details of cost, profit, normal loss, and abnormal gain also. So this is the method where we are calculating cost at each stage. Next question is, the process costing system is best suited for industry where different types of products are manufactured. Second option, where industry where homogeneous products are produced. B, service industry only. And D is all of the above. So here the answer for your second question is option B, industry where homogeneous products are produced. I have already discussed to you that the next important feature of process costing is under process costing is applied where the goods are standardized and homogeneous. Homogeneous here means same product which are not having any unique feature. You can't differentiate between those products. Now next question is, which is a feature of process costing? Option A, production against customer orders. Different types of product produced. Option B, production is for stock. And D is none of the above. So under process costing, we are producing goods not according to customer order. So option A is not applicable. All products are homogeneous under process costing. Again, option B is not applicable. Production for stock This is the correct answer for this question. So this is one of the feature of process costing is production is for maintaining stock. Question number second is product each of significant value produced simultaneously from the same raw material for same other processes. So the options are byproduct, joint product, common product and co-product, and the answer is joint product, because joint products are produced in the same process of production which is having significantly very high value as the main product. Next question is, when the actual loss is more than the estimated loss, the difference between the two is considered to be option A, abnormal gain, option B, abnormal loss, C, normal loss, D, normal gain. See, when we carry out manufacturing processes, so there is estimated loss because of the nature of raw material, because of some common feature that you can't avoid it because of the nature of your raw material. So we estimated some amount of loss, but when in actual, if the actual loss is more than the estimated loss, the answer is your abnormal loss, because we have not expected anything from estimated. So this is abnormal loss when it exceed the value of the estimated figure which we have thought before we begin our process of production. Now we'll move to question number. Next question is, wood pieces left in furniture industry should be treated as option A, byproduct, option B, joint product, option C, scrap, and option D, co-product. So the answer, wood pieces, the small pieces which are left in a furniture industry, so it won't be a byproduct, again it won't be a joint product, because that pieces that is left out is not having significant value as compared to your main product. So the correct answer for this question is, whatever wood pieces left out, that wood pieces will be treated as a scrap in furniture industry. Next question, the most important criteria for distinguishing between the joint product and byproduct, option A, cost, option B, sales value, option C, profit, option C, profit, option D, demand. See, I have already discussed in the beginning of this video, joint product and byproduct plays very important role in process costing. They are the product from the same manufacturing processes. When the value of that product is significantly high as compared to main product, it is joint product. And when the value is significantly very low, very small as compared to your main product, that is your byproduct. So what makes the difference between joint product and byproduct? The answer is sales value. Next is, which is not a feature of joint products? A, produced from the same raw material. Option B, produced simultaneously from same process. Can be sold without further processing. And option D is comparatively of equal importance. See, as we know that joint products are having very high value as the main product, so option D will be not valid. It is produced in the same process with the same raw material, So option A and B is again not applicable. So what is the correct answer for this question is option C. Option C can be sold without further processing. We can't sell joint product as it is. It required further processing. After further processing, the joint product will be in the process to be sold in the market as the main product. Next question is, which is an example of joint product? Wheat flour and brown flour in flour mill. Second, bread, cake and biscuits in bakery. Sugar and molasses in sugar meal. And none of the above. We know that joint products are having high significant value. So, the correct answer for this question is wheat flour and brown flour in the flour meal. See, option B, that is bread, cake and biscuits in a bakery. If you see these three things, the prices are differ. Breads is available in the market. Cakes are also available in the market, but the value of cake is more than the value of bread and biscuits. Sugar and molasses, if you talk about sugar value is relatively very high. Molasses, it's very low. Or we can say that molasses are the byproduct of sugar industries. So correct answer is A, wheat flour and brown flour. Two or more product of equal importance simultaneously produced from the same raw material are called option A, joint product, option B, byproduct, option C, co-product, and D, none of the above. And the correct answer is A, joint product. Because joint products are having equal importance and they are produced from the same raw materials. Next question is, one or more product of small value produced simultaneously in a product of greater value is called joint product, B, byproduct, C, co-product, D, none of the above. And the answer is byproduct, because byproduct is having very small value with the product which is produced in the manufacturing process. Next is process loss that occurs under inefficient working condition and is controlled is called abnormal loss, uncontrollable loss, and none of the above. Process loss that occurs under inefficient working condition and is controlled is called as abnormal loss. Abnormal loss means those loss which can be avoidable, which can be controlled by the management. Abnormal loss. Next is, which of the following statement is true for byproduct? Two or more product of small equal importance, secondary product incidentally produced, B, produced in a different product line, and D is all of the above. And the answer for this question is secondary product incidentally produced. As we know that byproducts are very small value as compared to your main product, but we can't avoid the production of byproduct. It is unavoidably produced and it is incidentally produced, and that's why we called it as a secondary product incidentally produced in the manufacturing process. Next question is, in an oil refinery, petrol and diesel are considered as joint product, byproduct, co-product, and none of the above. See, petrol and diesel both are having very high value. So the answer for this question is Option A, joint product. Dash process loss should be transferred to costing profit and loss account. Abnormal, actual, normal, all of this. And the correct answer for this question is abnormal loss. We should transfer this abnormal loss to costing profit and loss account for further calculation or for further treatment. Loss arising due to evaporation is considered as a dash in process account. Abnormal loss, normal loss, seasonal loss, none of the above. And your answer is normal loss. Why? Because we can't control the process of evaporation. It's a natural thing, and it's number of times this evaporation happens because of the nature of the raw material that you are using in your production process. Next is a process loss that does not affect cost per unit. And the answer is A, standard loss, B, abnormal loss, C, normal loss, D, seasonal loss. So the answer here is abnormal loss, because it doesn't have any impact on the cost per unit. Next is, in process costing, costs are accumulated by A, batch, job, C, production order, B, process, and the correct answer is option D, process. Because it's process costing, we have to calculate the cost at every process of manufacturing. Next question is, process costing is suitable for A, mass production industries, B, jobs of long duration, option C, organization rendering services, and D, production as per customer requirement. So the answer is, it is suitable for those industry which involved in mass production activity. Next, abnormal gain in a process is written to be credit side of process account, option B, debit side of process account, option C, debit side of costing profit and loss account, and option D is none of the above. See, under process costing, we have to treat abnormal loss, abnormal gain, and normal gain with accounting procedure, with proper accounting procedure. So we have to write this abnormal gain in the process account to the debit side. So here the answer is option B, debit side of process account. Next is, among the following, which method of costing computes cost at the end of each process? A, job costing, B, process costing, C, contract costing, D, batch costing, and the option is your process costing, because we have to calculate the cost at the each process. Loss which is unavoidable on account of nature of the material is called option A, controllable, B, normal, C, abnormal, D, none of the above. So the answer is normal loss. Why? Because we can't avoid this cost, because it is according to the nature of raw material that we are using in the production process. Loss which is avoidable is called A, uncontrollable, B, normal, C, abnormal, D, none of this. And the answer is C, abnormal loss. Yes, we can control the abnormal loss. we can avoid this normal loss with the help of efficient management, with the help of efficient cost controlling techniques to be applicable in the industry? So the answer is abnormal loss. Next is, the value of abnormal loss is debited on the basis, option A, normal cost of normal output, B, scrap value, C, cost of production, D, none of this. And the answer is normal cost of normal output. Next is, which statement is true about the treatment of abnormal loss? As I have already told you, we have to make the accounting procedure for normal loss, abnormal loss and abnormal gain. So here the question is all about how we are treating the abnormal loss. So the first, value is credited to process loss account. B, scrap value is credited to process loss account. B, balance in abnormal loss account is transferred to costing profit and loss account. And option D is none of the above. So the answer for this question is balance in abnormal loss account is transferred to costing profit and loss account. Because we know that in process costing, after we make process account, we have to create or we have to maintain a separate account known as costing profit and loss account, which calculate the processes cost and process benefit at the end. Next is, which form of operational costing applies where standardized goods are produced? A, marginal costing, B, process costing, C, batch costing, D, job costing. And the correct answer is option B, process costing. Why? Because under process costing, all goods are standardized and homogeneous goods. Which is true about process costing? Productions take long duration. Each output is customer specific. Production is done in batches and production is continuous. So the correct statement for process costing is production is continuous. When we talk about option B here, its output is according to customer specification. Under process costing, we are not manufacturing anything according to customer specification. We are not manufacturing anything into batches and we are not taking any manufacturing process for a long time. So what is applicable is under process costing, the production is continuous. Among the following, which industry is suitable for using process costing? A, chemicals, B, toys, C, builders, D, all of the above. And the answer is A, chemicals, because chemical require a various process, requires various process. So the correct answer for this question is A, chemicals. Which of the following businesses is likely to adopt a process costing system? Option A, plane manufacturers, B, construction companies, C, sugar refining units, D, printing presses. So the answer is C, sugar refining units. In process costing system, the manufacturing overhead is usually applied using predetermined rate, B, actual overhead rate, C, conversion overhead rate, D, direct overhead rate. And the answer is A, predetermined rate. Thank you for watching this video and all the best for your exam.